three children, welcome back to the online class. Children, in the previous video, we had started chapter 4 in the Kingdom of Fools, where we had discussed a detailed explanation from page number 20 to page number 23. Today, in continuation with the previous work, we shall carry on or we shall continue from page 23 to 26. Now children, in the previous class, just a short recap what we did. The rich man is summoned by the king. This is what we have discussed. Now children, the goldsmith was very smart and tactful. And he very smartly passed on the blame to the rich man. Now when the blame was passed on the rich man, the king, without giving another thought, you know, considered the rich man as the accused, and he was called in his fear. The rich man was shivering in fear because he knew the consequences. Because children, you cannot predict anything in the kingdom of fools. In the kingdom of fools, everything is unpredictable. So the rich man, when he was called, he was asked, you know, interrogation was done by the king. So during that interrogation, the rich man confirmed that he was not responsible, and he gave a very valid point to prove. Now what point did he bring? The point was that he said, the rich man, that it was his father who had ordered for the jewelry to that goldsmith. And since his father had ordered, so he should be, you know, hanged till death, or he should be executed. But since his father was not alive, he should be set free. The king got very much bewildered and confused after listening to this. He consulted his minister and came with a conclusion that since the rich man's father or the owner's father had already died, so the person who should be executed is none other than my rich man. Now the stake was made, children, and the rich man was supposed to be punished. The rich man had nothing to say because the king had already passed the order. But the minister and king, when they saw the rich man closely, they found that the stake which was made was not suitable for this rich man. Why? Because of his physical appearance. Because of his physical appearance, he was very thin. He was still very thin. So the king gives another verdict where he says that a man who is fat enough should be brought, and that man should be executed. Now his minister went here and there, people went here and there, and they found the disciple. Children, if you remember, the disciple was a food freak. He found things getting for a to-do. He used to eat too much, and because of that, he had grown fat enough, and the cover falls into his head. Now the disciple is called, and without any interrogation, the king gives his final verdict that he should be executed. Now children, the disciple is again very much afraid and frightened. He knew that he has nothing to say, and he won't be able to save himself because he had landed into a big trouble by choosing the kingdom of fools. So he started praying to his guru. And since the guru was very, you know, wise, he could understand or he could perceive the trouble of the disciple. During that very time, children, the guru uttered something through his magical powers. He though came also physically, but before that, he actually enunciated something into the disciple's ears. The disciple was now a bit confident that his guru would come and save him. Children, a guru is always a guru. Now, next stanza, children, the guru is trying to save his disciple. He comes there and according to the plan which was already prescribed and enunciated in the ears of the disciple, they start fighting. Both guru and disciple, they start fighting. The king and the minister, they get confused. Both of them, they get confused that what was going wrong. So the king came forward and asked the guru that why was he fighting with the disciple when he was supposed to be, you know, hanged till death or executed. The guru said, no, actually according to the state of word of justice, what I know or what I feel, you know, this is something which has come into my mind that whoever will die first will reborn as a king, and whosoever would die second will reborn as a minister. And that is the reason why I want to die first. The king gets astonished to hear this. Immediately they go into the private secret dungeon or a room, and both king and minister, they decide to die. As you can see in the next slide, the king decides to die. They go inside, you know, a dungeon or a very private place, and accordingly, through a mutual understanding, both the king and the minister, they come to a conclusion that the king would die first and the minister would die second. What they do? They hang themselves. The king hangs first and then the minister. Both of them dies. So king as well as the minister, they die. Children, the problem was solved. Did the guru use any logic? No. Logics are insane when you are dealing with foolish people. There what you need to apply is your wit and wisdom. This is actually the message of the story, children, that whenever you deal with foolish people, always use your mind, your wisdom, not logic. We did not apply. Did the guru apply any logic? Did he try to prove that the disciple was innocent? No. Now ultimately, the people of the kingdom finds the king and the minister dead. They take out the body, and the guru and disciple secretly, they slipped from there and they were moving. Now the people of that kingdom found no one as their king and minister. They requested, they begged the guru and disciple to rule over them. The guru and disciple decides that they would rule the kingdom only with one condition, and the condition would be laws, old laws to be changed. So the guru and the disciple becomes the king and minister. The laws changes there, and the kingdom now becomes a good, authentic and a proper kingdom. It is no longer a kingdom of fools. So children, what message do we get from the story? That is very important. First, children, never be, you know, engrossed with foolish people, otherwise always you will land up into a big problem. Avoid foolish people. Second very important thing is, do not apply your logic when you are dealing with foolish or stupid people. Apply your wit and mind. With this, we come to the end of the chapter. Children, read the chapter for better comprehension. Till then, have a good day. Thank you.